Carmelo Anthony and the Thunder will part ways. Remember, Melo opted into that $28 million contract for this season. When you add that up with the contracts of Westbrook and Paul George and Steven Adams, and you're talking about a guy who you can't even agree what his role is going to be, that is an unprecedented tax bill and something they had to get out of. So lots of questions here about what they should do. Should they wave and stretch? Should they try to trade him to a team that wants him, trade him to a team that's basically going to just cut him and sort of absorb the salary? But first, Byron, I want to ask you, why do you think it didn't work out with Melo and the Thunder?
I just think the style of play is a little bit different now with Melo. Melo is a great half-court basketball player. He's great ISO. He's a mid-post, low-post when there's certain guys that are guarding him. This game has evolved and it's changed. It's much more of a fast-paced game, and everybody wants to get up and down the floor and try to get easy buckets quick. So I think there's a number of teams probably that's going to take a real good look at Melo. I'm serious. I was trying to sit around and just think about what team he fits with, and I really couldn't find a team because of the fact that, number one, if he wouldn't take a diminishing role with the Thunder, what makes you think he's going to take one with a team that's a contender? So it was really hard for me to figure out where does he fit in the NBA, especially with a team that's contending.
Do you think he's going to have a shot to go to a contender? How do you think they're going to work this?
I think he's going to have a shot. The question is, does he want that shot? When that role is, like Coach said, is defined for you, you may not be starting. You may not be getting a lot of touches, a lot of shots. You're expected to be instant offense rather than, you know, how scores, they like to get their touches, feel the ball, feel out the game, get in the flow of the game. That's not kind of the role for contenders that he can fit in, which to me is why a team like Miami makes a lot more sense. It's out east. Mm-hmm. There's not a whole lot of competition out there. He can play the role of, I am the offensive workhorse.
He can start.
It's not only start, but offensively we go
be
to
the
you
man.
For buckets.
He could be the man. Yeah.
But it's also a team that's good enough to maybe win a couple of rounds in the playoffs if everything goes right. Now, he won't have to worry about his role, but he's going to have to buy in to Pat Riley's notorious body fat percentage, the boot camp,
training
all those
camp.
Things. Right. It's going to be a different style of life than any other franchise he's been with, but it gives him the best opportunity to continue to be who he is.
I actually like that fit for him off the court, too. We know that his son is still in New York City, and that's a little easier than, you know, Portland was floated earlier in the day. It's a little easier to get to Miami. Dwayne Wade, we don't know if Dwayne's going to actually play for that team next year or not, but he's going to be living there, so the Banana Boat buddies could hang out, you know, even on the off days or whatever. And I don't know. He was with a contender this past year. That contender getting booted in the first round. Who are you contending with this year? I mean, I guess he could come to the Houston, and we've heard the Rockets floating.
Houston would be the best team that he could join that makes sense.
Yeah.
But it's still going to be
a fit, though. I just don't see that as a fit for him. And again, the only way that works for me, Rachel, is that he really has to take a seat and say, okay, listen, I'm not going to be the man anymore. I'm going to be the second, third, fourth option at times. I'm not going to, like Amin said, I'm not going to get as many touches as I'm used to getting. Now, if he's willing to accept that role and just say, listen, I just want to focus in on winning, then Houston would be the best place for him.
But Byron, as you pointed out, he wasn't really willing to do that with the Thunder.
Like I said, if he's willing to accept the role and change his mindset, then that's a good place for him.